Be it the icy glacier of Siachen, the dense jungles of the northeast, the rugged terrain and lofty peaks of the Himalayas, or even the simmering hot desert of the Thar, the infantry soldier is undeterred by all odds and stays vigilant 24/7 to act as a first line of defense along the frontiers of our nation. As one of the three wings of our armed forces, the Indian Army has a clear-cut duty to defend our frontiers, border areas and thwart any war or infiltration aggression by the enemy with an aim to ensure national security and thereby maintain peace at all times. The infantry is one among the four major combat arms of the Indian Army. The other three include Armored Corps, Mechanized Infantry and Artillery. The battle-hardened infantry regiments form the bulk of the Indian Army's combat arms composition. An infantry regiment or battalion comprises of foot soldiers who are equipped with small arms which include assault rifles, machine guns, grenades to carry out combat raids on foot, hold strategic positions or vantage points and defend the posts, pickets and bunkers in forward areas all along the line of control and line of actual control and the international border. When on the offensive, they not only hold ground but also carry out charge on the enemy with their small to medium arms fire with assault rifles or machine guns fire, mortar shelling and throwing or lobbing grenades on enemy positions. Popularly known as the queen of the battle, the infantry remains the highly understated but the most pivotal point arm, most pivotal combat arm for the armies around the world. While its more and more mechanized counterparts, which include the Armored Corps and the artillery, provide devastating firepower to unleash carnage on the key enemy installations and garrison in the rear, the ultimate victory in any war is only accomplished when the daredevil infantryman lays claim or captures the enemy position and unfurls his battalion and nation's flag on that feature. Today, Indian Army is celebrating its 74th Infantry Day, and Indian Army's major officials, the Indian Air Force, Indian Navy, SSB crack exams and various other most important organizations and all the citizens of this nation wish them a very happy Infantry Day, and we feel very very happy and we must recognize their sacrifices that they have made for today. Let us begin with today's defense updates, that is of 26th and 27th of October 2020, and before beginning, I would like to introduce you that SSB crack exams is India's largest, most preferred online exams preparation portal. If in case you are preparing for various defense examinations, I would like to recommend you to download an Android app from Google Play Store. Then choose your favorite course, go through the complete lecture course content. Then you can also have a lot of important study materials, quizzes, sample practice questions, the practice exercises, which will be always helpful for your examination preparation. You can also follow us on all sort of social media platforms like Instagram, Twitter, Telegram, and you can always stay tuned with the most important defense updates all around India that will be helpful for your examination preparation. Now we will begin with the question of the day that I have asked on Saturday, that is on 24th of October 2020, and the question that I asked was, which artillery gun was inducted into the Indian Army on February of 7th, 2020? I repeat the question, which artillery gun was inducted into the Indian Army on February of 7, 2020, and you people were correct. Some of you have also been telling about Dhanush, but Dhanush was inducted on February of 5th of 2020. On February of 7th of 2020, we included the Sharang artillery gun. Okay, so Sharang is a very important artillery gun. It is still undergoing a lot of important trials. There is also an important defense updates regarding Sharang. Once we will go through the defense updates, once we started, we will understand about what I am trying to say. If we go through only the news regarding this particular question, here we have to understand that this Sharang artillery gun, which is an indigenously built one, it is going to be inducted on February of 7, 2020. It was inducted at that time, and this announcement was made by our army chief at that time. This 155mm Sharang is an upgraded version of M46 field guns. Please remember, Sharang is an upgraded version of M46 field guns, and this gun's range, the M46 had a range of around 27 kilometers only, but once it was upgraded, it is named as Sharang, and this artillery gun has a range of over 36 kilometers. This is very important. Chief of Army Staff has also announced that 6 Sauer assault rifles and Spike anti-tank missiles are also being issued to army troops who are deployed in the forward areas during that time, and the gun carriage factory, which is there in Jabalpur, it has upgraded the Sharang artillery gun along with ordnance factories and technical teams of army and the DRDO. That is it regarding the question of the day that I have posted before. Now we will have the first and foremost important defense update, and that is about the 74th Indian Army's infantry that army is celebrating today. And you have to remember that it was, why is it being celebrated today on 27th of October? It was at this time in 1947, the troops of the 1st Infantry Contingent, which include the 1st Sikh Infantry Battalion. So the 1st Sikh Infantry Battalion soldiers, they have landed at the Srinagar airfield. And after landing at the Srinagar airfield, they fought a very courageous battle with the Pakistani regular and irregular troops. What are regular troops? Regular troops include the Pakistani soldiers, and the irregular troops include the Pashtun and various other military groups and the terrorists that include also with the Pakistani troops, because Pakistan has a habit of promoting terrorism in Kashmir since the beginning itself. So to fight both the regular and irregular Pakistani troops, Indian Army has landed in Srinagar airfield and defended our territory. So it was from that day that we celebrate Indian Army's Infantry Day. So please remember, the Infantry Day celebrated on the 27th of October every year. Okay. So also we have to understand that the Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat and Army Chief General Manoj Mukund Narvane have paid the tributes at the National War Memorial. A short glimpse of that video is here for you. Now going through with the next most important update is regarding that the Raksha Mantri has held a bilateral delegation level meeting with his United States counterpart Mark Esper. The Mark T. Esper, who is the Honorable Secretary of Defense for USA, he is visiting India for the 2+2 ministerial meeting, and he already arrived India and he had a lot of important interactions, and lot of issues were discussed regarding the bilateral relationship between India and United States of America. All of these issues were discussed in the South Block in New Delhi, and he also welcomed Australia's participation in Exercise Malabar 2020, because we already got an update that Malabar 2020 exercise is going to be commenced very short. So he welcomed Australia's participation also in that, and he was briefed about Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan that is launched by the Indian Ministry of Defense for the indigenization of the Indian arms and products. If we go through details, that both the ministers have expressed their satisfaction at the close engagements between the respective armed forces. They discuss potential new areas of cooperation both at service-to-service level and at the joint level. They call for continuation of existing defense dialogue mechanisms during the pandemic at all levels, particularly the military cooperation group. They also discuss requirements of expanding deployments of liaison officers. The two ministers express satisfaction in that the agreement of the BECA will be signed during the visit. United States Secretary of Defense welcomed Australia's participation in Malabar 2020. Going through with the next most important update is regarding that the Myanmar Army has launched Operation Sunrise 3 to crack down the insurgent groups at Indo-Myanmar border. So this is very, very important one. The National Socialist Council of Nagaland, NSCNK, which is a terrorist group designated by the Indian officials and also by the United Nations abroad. So this group is led by Yung Aung, and it is consolidating its position inside Myanmar, and various other NSCN groups are also planning to attack Indian security forces at vulnerable points in the northeastern region, the northeast states. So to counteract among all of those important things, Myanmar Army has launched this Operation Sunrise 3. This is not the first time, this is the third time that Sunrise operation has been launched by the Myanmar Army. The first two operations were also held between both Indian Army and the Myanmar Army. So if we go through this, the Indian Foreign Secretary Mr. Harshvardhan Shringala and Indian Army Chief General Manoj Mukund Narvane are on a 2-day visit to Myanmar this month. If we go through in detail, that last year also Myanmar and our army have carried out the first phase of Operation Sunrise 1. This was between February of 17th and March 2nd. Okay, remember, from February of 17th to March 2nd, Operation Sunrise 1 was there, which was, and also another one, Operation Sunrise 2, was also launched on May of 16th on its own territory along the Indo-Myanmar border. This is the third time that this operation was launched yesterday, and it is said to have destroyed many camps of insurgent groups of the NSCN, which is based in the troops which is in Myanmar. And however, Myanmar army is also reported to have suffered a lot of loss in the second phase of Operation Sunrise 2. It is expected to be having securing the losses and incurring a lot of damage to the NSCN and completely curbing the terrorism which is included in Myanmar and which is based in Myanmar, which they have an ambition to completely strike down the security forces at the Indo-Myanmar border. Going through with the next most important update is regarding that India is going to get 5 military theater commands, one each for China and Pakistan by 2022. Remember, 5 military theater commands, one each for China and Pakistan by 2022. These commands are going to be inducted. So now these are 5 important commands. The first is the Northern Command. Next comes the Southern Command, Western Command, and also we also have a Maritime Command, and also a completely consolidated command is also there. If we go through the first Northern Command, it will have its beginning from the Karakoram Pass. Karakoram Pass is located somewhere here in our country in India. Okay, so from this particular pass, if we go through the border, all these borders, if you can see all the northern borders, if we go down more down, so crossing through Nepal and then coming crossing through Bhutan and all the way up to the points of the Bangladesh, all the way up to here, all of this red border that you are seeing, this border will be guarded. So this border, it begins from the Karakoram Pass and then it goes all the way up towards here, where it is, it goes to the outpost in Kibitu in Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh is somewhere here. So here we can find the Karakoram Pass. And then here we have the Arunachal Pradesh Kibitu, which is a very important locality of Arunachal Pradesh. So from Karakoram Pass to Kibitu, all of these borders will be maintained by the Northern Military Theater Command. And this, if we go through the distance of all of this red line that you are seeing, it is the 3488 kilometer LAC with China. Okay, so this is the headquarters of this command, would be Lucknow. Okay, Lucknow is somewhere here, and Lucknow is the headquarters for this particular command. So all of these will be inducted by what time? It will be inducted by 2022. The next important one, if we have to see, it is regarding that it was going to get 5 military ones. Then comes the Western Theater Command. So this will be from Indira Colony on Saltoro Ridge. It is somewhere here. And if you go down all the way up to here, so all of these borders will be maintained by the Indian Army's Western Theater Command. And this will have its headquarters likely in Jaipur. Jaipur is somewhere here. Okay. So here somewhere we will have the headquarters in Jaipur of the Western Command. And then comes the Peninsular Command. It will have its headquarters at Thiruvananthapuram, somewhere here. Okay. Here, if you can see, also the short form of Thiruvananthapuram is Trivandrum. So here we will have the southern completely. So all of this peninsular area will be guarded by the Indian Army's Peninsular Command. Then coming for the next command is regarding the fourth, which is the full-fledged air defense command. Okay, so this is an air defense command. This will not only spearhead the country's aerial attack, but also be responsible for defending Indian airspace through multi-role fighters, all aircraft missiles under its control. So this would be the air defense command. Then comes the Maritime Command. Maritime Command is possibility. Tri-Service Andaman Nicobar Command also will be merged with this. Now, what is a Theater Command? A Theater Command is that type of command wherein which all Indian Army, Navy, Air Force, and also the complete organization of the various different kinds of commands, including the mechanized infantry, artillery, the infantry regiment, and also the various other regiments, all of them will be working hand in hand so that we create a lot of important land-based, air-based, maritime-based proper security that will maintain and guard our borders, and by in which we can also understand and we can completely change the complete defense statistics that India is facing as of now. Okay, so these are the most important things. These are 5 military theater commands. So what are these theater commands? The first one is the Northern Command. Northern Command will be based at what place? It will be based at the Lucknow. Okay, all of these are not completely sure, but this is given by the recent inputs, and if there are any changes, we will provide from our side also. So completely stay tuned with the SSB crack exams to have a proper understanding. Then comes the second command. Second command is the what type of command? It is the Western Command. The Western Command is a very, very important command. It will be headed at the what place? It will be headed at Jaipur. Okay. Western Command will be there to completely fight with the Pakistani forces, and the Northern Command will be there to completely fight with the Chinese forces and the Chinese LAC. Then comes what type of command? The third command is a very, very important command. If you go through, the third command is a Peninsular Command. Okay. So this one is a Peninsular Command. Peninsular Command will be having its headquarters at what place? It will be headquarters at the Thiruvananthapuram. And then comes the fourth command. Fourth command is an Air Defense Command. Air Defense Command has a completely air defense assets, including all Army, Navy and Air Force will be working here. This will be a completely one. The headquarters of the Air Defense Command is not given, and if it is given, we will inform to you. Also, if in case you have any idea, please mention in the comment section. Then comes the fifth most important command, and that is what type of command? It is the Maritime Command. It is a full-fledged, completely Maritime Command, and this will cover all the important maritime assets of our country. So all the Andaman Nicobar Tri-Service Command is also expected to work hand in hand in coordination with the Maritime Command. Okay, that is it regarding this most important update. Going through with the next most important update is regarding that India, we have to also understand that the Chief of Defense Staff will have the Armed Forces Special Operation Division. If in case this Maritime Command, the Tri-Service Andaman Nicobar Command, if it gets merged with the Maritime Command, then we have to understand that CDS will get extra powers and commands. Regarding the powers of the Chief of Defense Staff, he will have separate Special Operation Division of the Armed Forces. He will have a separate Cyber Command under his supervision, and the Defense Intelligence Agency will also be working under him, and all the manpower will be drawn from all the three services. Okay, this is a very, very important update. The next most important information is regarding that the United States Navy adds more muzzle to its arsenal. It goes hypersonic. That means what? All the destroyer ships of United States Navy are now getting hypersonic. Okay, this is for the first time that the complete military strategy is going to change regarding the United States of America. This is very, very important. It is a significant policy and operational change to its complete military doctrine of the United States of America. This is for the first time that it announced that all the destroyers are now being equipped with hypersonic missiles. More than 100 destroyers are there in the United States Navy. If all of them become hypersonic, then it is very, very clear message sending towards China that it has to reduce its suppressionist military strategies. Going through the next update, that we have to understand that spelling out the ambitious plan, Robert O'Brien, who is the Secretary of the United States, he talked about the Navy's conventional prompt strike program to provide hypersonic missile capability to hold targets at risk. If we go through in detail regarding this particular one, he suggested that deployment of these will be first on Virginia class submarines. Okay, first it will be going through the Virginia class submarines. About 22 are there in the United States Navy, and then it will be followed out by the most advanced stealthy Zumwalt class destroyers, and also in the final phase all of these missiles will be deployed on the Arleigh Burke class destroyers, which are about 62 in the United States Navy. The next important update is regarding that the Rajnath Singh is reviewing the line of actual control at Army's Trishakti Corps in Sukna. This he reviewed on 25th of October 2020 on Sunday. He visited the Darjeeling District Trishakti Corps. Trishakti Corps has its original name. It is the 33 Corps. Okay, 33 Corps is the official name, and it has been nicknamed as the Trishakti Corps. Okay, so it is based in Darjeeling, and he was there on a 2-day visit to the West Bengal and Sikkim to review the military preparedness in view of the border with China. He also performed Shastra Puja, which means the worship of weapons, at Sharatang area in Sikkim on Sunday morning on Dashara. A brief look about Shastra Puja is here for you. The next important update is regarding Army Commanders Conference 2020. This is scheduled from 26th to 29th of October 2020. Today is 27th of October, so today is the second day of this particular Commanders Conference. It has also already commenced and it is still going on. It is a very, very important event where in which all the commanders of the Indian Army from all sort of commands will be coming together, will be sitting, briefing, talking together, and they will make out plans to completely review and guard the Indian Territory Forces. And this is to ensure due diligence. Decisions are taken through collegiate system comprising Army commanders and various other senior officers. And the final update for us, as I was telling you while I was explaining the question of the day, that we already had a very important update regarding the Sharang artillery gun system. This has been completely indigenized, and the first type of this one is now being test-fired at the Long Proof Range, Khamaria. Okay, so LPR Khamaria, it is a place. The commandant of LPR Khamaria, Brigadier Nishchaya Raut, he informed that pressure waves are being studied through this particular artillery gun. Okay, so there is a chamber portion of artillery gun and also barrel portion is also there. This is a very, very important one. So the pressure differences of the ones that is being fired, the complete testing is being done and all of this is being tested. And all of these, why are we studying about all of these? Because these are the Sharang and the Dhanush artillery guns, the barrels that were there, these were designed by the Indian ordnance factories. Okay, so we have to understand that all of these barrels, for the first time, the differential pressure phenomenon is being tested for the first time, and all of these pressure versus time data will be recorded on real time basis, and all of these data will be sent back to IIT Kanpur. Okay, so IIT Kanpur will study all of these studies and then it will give out the proper inputs regarding this particular one. So we have to understand how deeply the research and the military deployment development process is being taken out when the army's indigenization is being concerned. So we have to appreciate Indian Army, IIT Kanpur, LPR Kamaria and all of the other important officials who are directly and indirectly involved in this important indigenization. Now we will have a very quick review by going through some of the most important questions. And the first and foremost question is, Indian Army celebrates Infantry Day on what date? It will be celebrating its Infantry Day every year on today, that is on 27th of October. So we have to remember that on 27th of October, Indian Army has landed its first troops in Srinagar airfield. So marking the Indian Army's position and outpost for the first time in Kashmir, we celebrate Infantry Day on this day on 27th of October. Going through the next important question is, Indian military is expected to be reorganized under how many theater commands by 2022? It is expected to be reorganized under 5 theater commands by 2022. The next question is, Trishakti Corps original name is? It is the 33 Corps. The next question is, Rajnath Singh performed Shastra Puja, the worship of weapons, in which state on the occasion of Dasara? He performed the Shastra Puja in Sikkim. Okay, in the Shirathong area in Sikkim, he performed Shastra Puja. He was on a two-day visit to both West Bengal and Sikkim, and he was reviewing the operational preparedness of the Indian troops in the wake of the control of the suppressionist regime of the China. Going through with the next important question is, this year's Army Commanders Conference is scheduled from what date to what date? It is scheduled from 26th to 29th of October 2020. The next question is, long proof range LPR Kamaria successfully conducted study of pressure waves from which indigenously designed artillery gun system yesterday? It is the Sharang artillery gun system. Now we will have the question of the day, and the question of the day for today is, which squadron of Indian Air Force has recently inducted Dornier DO-228 aircraft in its fleet? Okay, so I repeat the question, which squadron of Indian Air Force has recently inducted Dornier aircraft in its fleet? The answer for this and the important updates and the reviews regarding that particular squadron will be given to you in the next session. Until then, stay tuned to SSB Crack Exams, subscribe to this channel, download our Android app from Google Play Store. Stay safe, stay healthy. Jai Hind.